a society based around movement, transportation, changing technology, time, often forgets the smaller, finer things. As a collective group of people, we have become so immersed in our synthetic world that we ignore the natural. We see the cars, the trains, the colossal buildings that touch the sky, but too often do we forget that there's another world all around us, the tiny, minuscule world that encompasses the artificial structures and the people that made them. Students at Temple City High School were asked about their awareness of nature and how they feel about the environment we live in. While some believe that a city is the place to be, others feel that nature should have a larger role in society.
I'd rather live in the city because there's more to do, and you could just like drive to farm or wherever is natural, I guess.
I guess I prefer to live in the city because things are more nearby, and like if I wanted to look at nature, I can just like drive a bit far out.
I would prefer to live in the city because that's where everything is at, and somewhere more natural is boring because all there is flowers, leaves, nothing you do with them. And city, you have arcades, you have the mall, you have everything else, so that's my answer.
I would prefer to live in somewhere more natural because I think it's more healthy because the air is cleaner, and then I think it would be fun if I planted my own food to eat because that's cheaper anyway.
I think I prefer to live somewhere more natural. Partly because I never really had the chance to be, you know, outdoors, like camping. I think it would be an interesting experience, and I just like nature.
If I had to choose between living in a city or a place that's more natural, I think I'd choose something that's a little more natural. Maybe not the big city with all these tall buildings, but at least some sort of parks and recreational places.
I think about nature every day because it's like all around us.
I think about nature every morning when I get out of the house because we look at our flowers in the garden and stuff. And then we also look at the mountains on the car ride to school.
I don't really know why, but I actually never take the time to look at my surroundings. But occasionally when I walk home, I do look at the trees and the flowers. But if I'm just like driving past, like in a car, then no.
I don't think about nature very often because it's all around me and I usually don't notice things that's around me.
Honestly, I do not think about nature that often because I'm very busy with school.
I feel like we're not living in a really good environment. I mean, it's like it's not horrible, but it's not the best it could be.
Well, I'm really worried because I feel like the whole world is starting to get these really tall 250,000 story buildings, and then there's not enough parks and other places where trees can grow. And when I go into the city, I don't see any trees on the sidewalks, and that worries me.
Caught in the rush of innovation and the movement to move further into the future, we forget to stop and pay attention to what was here before the steel and plastic world. We forget to remember the smell of sweet air and instead taint it with smog and pollution. We forget to acknowledge the tiny creatures, the ants, the spiders, the bugs that lives beneath us and with us. We forget to stop and notice the details in the precious leaves that are falling fast. And we forget to appreciate the brilliant, vibrant colors in the flowers that may one day fade. In the words of Marcel Proust, only in suffering do we recognize beauty. Only when we lose what was dear to us do we realize the importance of its existence. But how long must we wait before we recognize the beauty that we are losing?